Good morning, everybody. Happy Thursday. It's February 29th. It's a leap day. First time we've had one of these in 4 years. Of course, they come every 4 years. Leap day, February 29th. Oftentimes, not every single time, a positive day for the markets. 75% of the time for the past 60 some odd years, we've had a positive day on February 29th. Great to be with all of you today. My name is Bob Lang and I run explosiveoptions.net. And an amazing, fantastic chat room with some incredible people, incredible traders. We've had a great week so far. And if you're not in the chat room, my question to you is why not? So we get a chance to make some good money, learn a lot about trading and options. Let's talk about what happened here. So about 20 minutes ago, I was looking at the markets and they were pretty weak coming into the inflation numbers that were coming out. And we can see here what I'm talking about here. So in the middle of the night, about 2:33 o'clock in the morning, we saw futures falling sharply and they kind of went sideways for several hours over here, and then a big huge pop right after that PCE number came in, and we're following through to the upside and approaching 5100 on the futures. That's important because we had a commensurate drop in volatility here. And why is it important? It's because that people were looking for this market to continue to go down. We've been down mostly every day this week. And as was the script last week, where we were down the first couple of days after the holiday, Thursday was a humongous rise up. And of course, that was followed by that was after the big NVIDIA earnings that came out Wednesday night. And so we may get a nice hustle up here at the end of the month. Is this window dressing? Is this something different going on here? I don't know. I thought a lot of that window dressing was going to be to the sell side coming in today. Boy, was I wrong. And that's fine. I have positions in place to take advantage of the markets in either direction here. So we had some earnings coming out last night. Of course, Salesforce came out with some good earnings, but not so great guidance. We had Snowflake, which is melting as we speak, SNOW. We had good, strong earnings from Okta, aka OKTA. This morning, we had some good earnings from Best Buy and also Celsius. And those stocks are likely higher today. Tonight, we have some big earnings coming out. DELL, which is a big holding of mine, is going to be reporting earnings. Zscaler as well, too, which I've been adding this week. ZS is the symbol on that one. And then Autodesk comes out with earnings, and along with VEEV Systems, VEEV. So I'm looking for some ideas here. I'll show you some of these charts in a little bit. Let's take a look at the charts over here. So we've got the oscillators down here on the bottom. Ignore this top chart with the SPY for a moment. The oscillators here, we have the NASDAQ oscillator up on the top, the New York Stock Exchange oscillator here on the bottom, and we can see that they're slightly negative right now. And if the markets hold their upward movement today, if there's probably a lot of short covering going on in the past 20 minutes or so. But if the markets hold this up move here today and we get some good internals, good statistics, this is going to be positive again and make a run up here. So we had a brief move above the zero line here on the NASDAQ, not on the New York Stock Exchange. But once we get above zero and can stay up there, I think the markets can move strongly. Look, tomorrow is the first trading day of March, and we often see money flows coming in at the start of the month. So tomorrow being the first day, and then into next week, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, we could see a little bit of momentum. I think I'm going to show you the S&P 500 chart in just a moment here. We can see that some of that momentum from the prior week has burned off a little bit. Certainly the last 4 days have been slightly negative. But take a look here. This is interesting. Take a look here. So you can see the markets have been sort of sliding down, but on lower volume, right? Which is kind of what you want to see. You don't want to see expanding volume when the market's going down. You want to see expanding volume when the market is going up. And you want to see lower volume as the market is going down. And why is that? It's because the sellers will show less conviction of getting out of the market. So just basically pulling back, removing some of the froth that's been created. It certainly was created from this one day where the markets were up almost 2% in one session. So we have these things happen. Markets get extended, they pull back a little bit, they get extended, they pull back a little bit, extended, pull back, extended, pull back. So that's just the textbook pattern of higher highs and higher lows, a market that is in an uptrend. So we have the S&P 500 certainly showing those characteristics. With the volatility here, I want to show that I did show you the VIX futures were sharply lower. And, you know, again, this is something that is a little bit concerning over here, right? And you can see clearly that the VIX has been in a modest uptrend here. It's making higher lows and some higher highs over here. Now, if it drops below 13 and it stays below, what I talked about a couple weeks ago is when the VIX is below the 20-day moving average, which is the dotted line here, and the 200-day moving average, which is the black line here, that is bearish for volatility, bullish for markets, all right? So you understand that this is a good indicator for you to pay attention to if you want to stay long the markets or if you want to buy some protection. Now, certainly in the middle of the month, we had a big spike up above 18 here, and we flirted with breaking out above the 200-day moving average, but it just didn't happen, right? And then last week, we had that big surge in the markets and a big drop in volatility. Which basically said what? It said that market players are really not interested in buying put protection as insurance right now. And that's fine. You know, I mean, eventually all this low volatility is going to get paid back in a way. You want to see what low volatility looks like here? Let's look at the weekly chart of this, and you can see how flat the volatility has been for the past couple of months, certainly since October, right? Between 15. Now, this isn't scaled very well, but this is between 15 and 12 here for the past 4.5 months, right? Eventually, that's going to get paid back. And it always does. And nobody will really be able to catch up to it. So that's why I'm always advocating having some put options on and having lots of cash available when opportunities present themselves. Are we going to see some opportunities today? Absolutely. So we're going to be able to take advantage of those, some of those opportunities and trade this market, right? So let's see, what else do I want to show you here? Again, futures are pushing higher. I did add some SPY calls that are expiring on the 12th. I did add some puts yesterday too, or towards the close, on the poor earnings from some technology names, and those aren't going to do very well, so I maybe just be punting those today. So what are some stocks that I'm looking at here today? So again, I told you about a couple of earnings plays. I'm looking at Microsoft here as well too. That is not an earnings play idea, but again, this is a stock that had this huge run in January and is tailing off a little bit here and flirting with that 20-day moving average. I think this is a good spot to start adding some Microsoft on a trade. I'm also today we do have Dell earnings coming out after the close. So take a look at this chart. This stock has been very, very strong. And again, this is a stock that's been it's in the data center, it's in the cloud. It's working on some AI initiatives as well too. And they didn't do very well on their earnings last time around. You could see that at the end of November, last time around, the stock was making a big move here, but it fell back and it went back into an uptrend over here, and it's at an all-time high over here, about $92, $93. I think the stock's got some room to $100 eventually. And then we've got VEEV Systems, which is one that I've been looking at here. And again, this one, you might argue that, okay, well, double top here from back in September, that's bearish, right? And you could certainly argue that. But I would look at this. Let's see. Let me draw this up here. What do you see here? Inverse head and shoulders here, and trying to break through a neckline here at about 225. So if we get through that 225 level, boy, this thing measures out really high. So about from 165 or 163 to on the bottom of the head. The inverse head and shoulders, remember something, is bullish, whereas a regular head and shoulders is bearish. So this would be bullish. So you make a low, and then you make a lower low, and then you make a higher low on the right shoulder, left shoulder, head, right shoulder here. And then from 162 to 200, that's 40 points. So 40 points, throw 40 points on top of here. We're talking 265 to 270 potentially on VEEV system. So this is one that I'm going to be looking to add some exposure today. Next one is a Zscaler. Now, Zscaler is one that I like a lot. And it pulled back a little bit yesterday, had a really nice pullback here when Palo Alto Networks came out with their earnings, but it exploded right back up for about 4 or 5 days, pulled back a little bit here. Now, I want to show you something on the Chicken Analytics, right? This is something that I use regularly. So Chicken Analytics, it's only showing neutral. It was bullish, but the power gauge just changed to neutral. So I'm hesitating a little bit over here. But money flow is strong. Relative strength versus the SPY is strong. Overbought, oversold, this is pulling back a little bit here. So I think the trends are strong. The point is that I think the stock has pulled back enough, and I think we can get a good move up towards 255, 260 eventually. Zscaler, that's ZS on the ticker. So one more chart I want to show you as well too. We've been tracking this for quite a while, and from time to time, new highs, new lows continue to expand. They're very, very healthy right now. In fact, let me put the solid line here for you guys. There we go. So we see good, healthy prints above the zero line, right? And that, as long as we're seeing good, solid, healthy prints above here, the market's healthy. Okay. So as long as we're in the box here, we stay in the box. If we go below the box, then we have a little bit of a problem here. So anyhow, that's going to be it, everyone. Thank you very much for spending a little bit of time with me. Oh, and a quick reminder, today is Leap Day. So we are having our Leaps webinar at the end of the day, probably close to 4:45. I have a tennis lesson at 3. Hopefully going to be back about 4:30 and open the room up for all of you guys. I'll be sending out invites again. I've been doing it all day, all week long. So you should be seeing those. The Leaps webinar is the most popular. It's the most highly attended webinar of the year. And I look forward to seeing all of you guys there. We'll talk about what Leaps are, long-term equity appreciation instruments. We'll also talk about the trades from last year, 2023, and we'll set up some new trade ideas. I have a whole list of them. Sam DeMarco, who is our spread trader extraordinaire, who did a great webinar for us yesterday, is going to be joining with me as well too, and has some diagonal trade calendar ideas for you as well too. So I'm really looking forward to this. I love this webinar. It's my favorite one, and we're going to have a great time on this today. So make sure you're there. Don't miss out on this webinar. It's going to be a lot of fun. 4:45 p.m. roughly Eastern time. So have a great day, everyone. I appreciate everyone spending a little bit of time with me, and some of the new people who are watching us today. Thank you for spending a little bit of time and listening to what I do. And hopefully you get a chance to join us in the chat room one of these days. And I won't be probably beyond next week. I'm going to be out of town, returning probably on the 11th or 12th of March. I will see what I can do. Maybe I might be able to sneak in a Daily Bites here next week while I'm gone. So anyway, thank you, everyone. Have a great trading day. Don't forget, keep some protection, have some cash, be ready for what the market's going to throw at us in the next couple of sessions. All right. Have a great day, everyone. And I'll see you guys all when I get back. Take care. Bye. And I feel